I think I've written this scene before, but I'll write it once again. I think I've written this scene before, but I'll write it once again. In a boat upon the lake, a woman and a man. High above in the dark sky stands the moon. The night is still and warm, just right for this dreamy adventure. The dark mountain lies like a giant on the glistening water. No noise, no sound. No noise, no sound. Everything is wrapped in a black, sweet silence. The stars tremble high above in the sky, and also upward from far below, out of the sky, which lies on the surface of the water. The water is the friend of the moon. The water is a friend of the moon. It has pulled it down to itself, and now they kiss, the water and the moon. They kiss the water and the moon. The moon has sunk into the water like a daring young prince into a flood of peril. He is reflected in the water like an affectionate soul, reflected in another soul. How the moon resembles the lover drowned in pleasure. How the water resembles the mistress embracing her kingly love. The oars lie lazily on the water. In the boat, the man and woman, completely still. A long kiss holds them captive. A long kiss holds them captive. Are they happy? Will they be happy? The two here in the boat, the two here who kiss one another, the two here upon whom the moon shines, the two here who are in love, the two here who are in love. A long kiss holds them captive, the two here who are in love. I think I've written this scene before, but I'll write it once again. I'll write it once again. For the two here who are in love, the two here who are in love, for the two here who are in love. A long kiss holds them captive. Two here.